Hey guys, what is going on? So I love watching movies in Mandarin Chinese. You know, I think it's a great way to engage myself, to see the conversation and dialogue take place and how it's spoken, all of it. But the problem is, whenever I'm watching a movie on Netflix, there's no Pinyin, you know? And at this point, like, I'm still like figuring the characters out. I'm not paying, like, I don't know a lot of the characters and their exact sounds. So I need Pinyin to understand that. At this point, like, if you're watching a movie on Netflix, all you're going to get is characters, simplified characters or traditional characters, but that's all you get. There's no way to get the Pinyin, but I've actually found a solution to this. So we're gonna get to the solution, but before I do, I just wanna play my intro. It's a brand new thing, so let me know what you think about it.
Hey, I'm this guy who wants to learn Mandarin Chinese and maybe other languages too. Welcome to my channel.
Alright guys, welcome back. So to get the Pinyin on Netflix, basically what you gotta do is that there's a Chrome extension that you have to download to a browser, which is Language Learning with Netflix. Okay, once you download it and you get on Netflix, it's just gonna work automatically. As long as the movie has the subtitle for simplified Chinese or traditional Chinese characters, they should work without any problem. So for example, right now, as you can see, I've selected over here simplified characters, and the audio is also in Mandarin, and I'm gonna play this video. So the really cool part about this is that whenever I hover over the characters over here, the video will pause automatically. And as you can see guys, like, I'm getting three translations. On the upper line, I have the Pinyin, and then I have the characters, and then I have the translation in English at the very bottom. But what happens is that as I hover over the characters, I get the exact definition of that character. As you will see, if I move my mouse away from the characters, the video will just resume automatically. Another awesome thing about this Chrome extension is that, let's say if the dialogue is being said and something was said too quickly and you missed on it, now you want to get back to that exact same point. To do that, all you have to do is that on the right hand side over here, what you have is your dialogue box. So basically, you can just pause wherever the video is and click on the dialogue, and you hit the play button over here. So the video will go to that exact same point in time when that dialogue was said. In this situation, you have the definition down below, which is our current occupancy rate is above 38%. Now over here, you have the Pinyin and the characters, but you can get the exact definition of those characters. For example, Liu Dongjin, liquid gold. Okay, occupancy rate, Zhang Yong Liu Zai at 38%. Above, Yi Shang. So you're basically understanding, like, you're getting to really understand how the grammar structure is and how the words are placed. And you know, this really gives you a very deep understanding of the language. I honestly think this is like the best way to mine sentences. You know, if you're watching something on Netflix, you might as well take it really slow, you know. Just go dialogue by dialogue, see how things are said. Do you think you're gonna use this sentence in the future? So write them down in your notebook, you know, take notes and practice those sentences. And you know, the best part of it is that it's absolutely free. So, I mean, there is a paid version for it. What the paid version will allow you to do is that it's gonna allow you to save all the dialogues. So you have the save items over here. Right now, for me, it's empty, as you can see, because that's a pro feature. I'm not sure how much is the charge. I think it's about $4 something. It's not that expensive, but they do have that feature. But honestly, like, I personally prefer to just write them down in a book, like I said, because first of all, just the act of writing that Pinyin down will already help me remember the sentence. And I can always have that book with me whenever I want to practice. I'm not always going to be opening up my computer and getting on this Chrome extension to get to those sentences. So I personally prefer writing them down in the book, but everyone has their own preference. So if you do want to save them directly from the dialogue box over here, you can do that, but that's a pro feature, like I said. Yeah, I think this is an amazing way to really immerse yourself into the language. But I honestly just found out about it like 2 weeks ago. And I was just like, man, I have to make a video about this. So this is it. You know, if you got something out of this video, make sure to leave me a thumbs up. And if you want me to keep uploading similar videos, make sure to subscribe. That's it for now, guys, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye.